Hello, this is Lara Rubbelke with Azure Friday, and today we're talking about Hive LLAP, or Interactive Query. And I've got MK, who is with our engineering team over on HDInsight, to share some of the things that we can do with Hive LLAP. So you want to tell us a little bit about what you guys are focused on right now?
Absolutely. Hi, folks. First of all, this is a feature of HDInsight. HDInsight, as you know, is the open source PaaS platform that we offer in Azure. And Hive LLAP basically takes it to the next level. What you can do, if you can think about a traditional analytical warehouse, what do? You take data from a lot of different sources. It could be your log files. It could be your custom apps or your real-time IoT data. It's flowing in through Data Factory and everything else. Eventually, it ends up in a storage, like typically Azure storage. From then, you got to do a lot of processing if you want to do any sort of queries on it, right? So you do through ETL and like probably several hours later, and then yes, you can do a SQL query on it. What Hive LLAP does, this is an Apache project that we now create a platform around it in HDInsight, lets you start querying those files ASAP.
Great.
So you shorten this entire time from sort of data to insights using Hive LLAP.
Right, and that's all around that concept of schema later or applying the schema at the query time, right?
That's correct.
Yeah.
So you can actually create these Hive sort of external tables, if you will. Mm-hmm. You don't have to load or populate the tables. These are just files sitting in your data lake, and you're just querying on them.
That's fantastic, fantastic. What would you like to show us?
Yeah, so just let me give you like a quick intro into what LLAP is.
Okay.
So when you see the demos, you kind of know what's happening.
Great.
So first of all, it's super fast performance. So imagine querying like petabyte scale files in seconds, right? So we'll show some demo with the 100 terabyte database. Commodity storage, right? You don't need any specialized storage, none of that stuff. It's just regular raw data lake. ACID, it actually supports transactions if you do updates. Right, and then concurrency. We have done like 64 concurrent corrections. That's the benchmark we have published on the web. It's super fast compared to every other open source engine out there, and particularly tuned for Azure. And the other cool part is a lot of our customers, like pretty big customers, are trying it where they put a load balancer in front, and they're able to scale to hundreds of users.
Oh, fantastic.
Right, and finally, security, right? Security is paramount to any enterprise, and this is fully integrated to the Apache Ranger framework, so you can make sure that anything that's cached or anything that's queryable is fully sort of backed by security. Of course, it's super easy to use. It's just SQL. We'll show you that sort of simple demo on that. On the right side here, you see the sort of the simple, trivial sort of architecture of it. You have the storage sort of data lake. You have the metastore, which is the high metastore.
And by metastore, that is?
Just the metadata, right?
Just
that says,
the metadata.
Okay, here's the file, or here's potentially the schema of that file. That's it done, right?
And that allows you to reuse that metadata across different kinds of queries.
That is correct.
Right.
And across engines too,
right?
The Hive metastore is kind of the common store that Spark uses, the Hive uses, Hive LLAP uses, right?
Right.
And all this is, if you look at sort of the LLAP daemon and the memory SSD cache, that kind of architecture there, all it's saying is if you spin up a Hive LLAP cluster, it's basically trying to auto sort of pull these files into the cache. Mm-hmm. It automatically takes care of caching. You don't have to do anything.
Okay.
If the file's kind of a new file you add to the storage, it'll automatically pull it up, right? Or if the file's changed, it'll automatically pull it up. And it caches it in memory and the SSD drives on those machines, so that way you get like super fast performance.
Great. Now, you mentioned commodity storage, and you've got, you talk about how we can connect to Azure Blob or ADLS. Are there formats or file formats that we're restricted to for using?
No. This is the cool part of it, right? So you can imagine CSV files that you get, which is kind of a popular format. You can just start querying them ASAP. You don't have to convert them into any format. Now, if you convert that to ORC, it's faster because it's a columnar format. It can do sort of pruning and everything. But if you just want to query raw files, absolutely, you can do that.
And JSON and Parquet.
Yes,
and,
that's correct.
So you can use that data as it's been ingested. You don't have to do all the conversion. You
that
can
is correct.
Get the immediate benefits.
That is correct.
That's great. That's all great. Right. All right, let's see more.
Okay. All right, let me jump into the demo. And before that, this is kind of typically what you go through. You create the HDI cluster. We have a special offering called the Interactive Query. We don't call it LLAP. We call it Interactive Query. And all you have to do is just upload your data and start querying.
Okay.
So we'll see the demo right now. So here's the Azure portal, as you're familiar with the Azure portal. So basically what I have a cluster here called HDInsight cluster, and this is an interactive cluster. So I'm just going to go to the cluster dashboard. So this is probably familiar for people who know HDInsight. And we offer a bunch of cluster dashboards, Zeppelin notebooks, and so on. I'm going to open up the cluster dashboard. And this is a familiar Ambari service, which kind of shows you all of the nodes in there in the system. You can see the disk usage, the health of all the various components. And for people who are familiar, there is the Hive View 2.0. And if I open up the Hive View 2.0, this is kind of the syntax that you get, which is, hey, it shows you all the metadata that it's aware of, right? Remember, these are just tables. This is a file sitting in the data lake.
Right.
Right? And what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to create a new table. Let's just call it demo AFP, right? And I'm going to upload the data. So here's, if you see the first, it says it's a file, it's a CSV file. And I'm just going to say the first row is header information. So this is the file I'm going to upload. So this is basically just saying what's the forecast for the how home prices to change in the various states. So as you can see, it's just a CSV file with the states and potential forecast, right? So if I go back, so I'm just going to say it's a CSV file. The first row is a header. I'm just going to say you can either upload from an HDFS file if it already exists in other sources or a local file. So in this case, I'm going to choose from the local file. And basically, if I go to the documents, so you see this all regions for public CSV. And see, immediately, it just read the CSV file. Mm-hmm. It showed you this is the schema that it saw in the CSV file. And so here, potentially, you can go and change any of these things. So like, if you feel the region name should be maybe an integer instead of a string, right, you can do all that. Or if you don't like some of the columns, you can delete that too, right? So that's all I have to do. And actually, if you can see, it even shows a preview of the file. This is the same file that I just showed you right now. So I'm going to say create. What this is doing, it's uploading that. It's doing a bunch of things, right? First, it's creating the actual table. When I say create the table, it's just a metadata row in the Hive schema store. Then it's uploading the data, right? This from my local file all the way up. In this case, I've asked it to also make it into an ORC format. So it's kind of doing that as well.
So that gets you the advantages of performance while you're querying.
That's right.
So it now, does the conversion during the upload.
The only problem is I forgot to change the name of the table. So I had already created the table. So let me call that demo all regions. And I just say create. So it's creating the actual table. It's going to upload it, right? Put the files in there. And it's also converting to an ORC format because I've asked it to do so. So the way it also does, this is a characteristic of Hive, it first puts the data into a temporary table, just so that, like in case errors happen, you don't mess up the data.
Right.
And then it actually then inserts into the real table, right, which is the ORC format, and now it's done, right?
Okay.
So it's loading the table information. As you can see, it has actually created a real table, right? This is the DDL it actually did. If you just wait a sec. So this is a demo all regions, and you can see this is the table it actually created, right? And you can see what's the row format in. It's saying the format is actually an ORC format. ORC is the sort of column optimized format, if you remember, right? And then this is just a bunch of storage information, more detailed information on kind of the size of the file, some statistics. It's one file with like 34,000 rows and so on and so forth, right?
Great.
That's kind of the table information. Now let's start having some sort of, let's start doing some queries and see where we go. So let's see. The table was select star from, we call the table,
demo all regions, I believe.
Yes, we call that all regions. Was that all regions for
demo
public?
Demo all regions.
Oh,
right here.
Yeah, there you go. Yes, demo all regions. Let's limit the 10 rows, so just so that we can see how the results are.
So SQL,
It's just plain SQL.
It's just SQL.
Right. You saw that it's a select star. Yep. I can put a where clause in there, right?
Yep.
And so it's just plain SQL. Imagine I didn't have to do any ETL. All I did was upload the file, and you got the results back. Now, a few things I wanted to show you, right? This is one thing. So this is kind of the Hive 2.0 sort of viewer. And if you like this sort of view, great. You can use this. But often, more often than not, you probably have data scientists who want to start using notebooks that they're very familiar with, right? They want to start exploring the data. Right? And so what the cool part about this Hive LLAP is fully integrated with the notebook experience, right? So here you go, the same, we call that demo for public, if I remember right, demo all regions, right? Let's run the query here. And you can see, I can start like doing some data exploration, right? So for example, this is the forecast. So if I put a value in here, you immediately see the values, right, as like a visual experience.
And that's all right in that same cluster.
That is correct, right? Okay. I did not have to like do anything different. Mm-hmm. And so a data scientist can use that same data. Again, we did not curate the data. We didn't move it anywhere. And you see the response times. Mm-hmm. This is on raw data, right? And so so we showed sort of notebook experience, the Hive 2 experience, and obviously being an open source code, we also work with all the open source sort of tools out there.
Great.
Another cool one that you're familiar with is a Visual Studio sort of code, and we integrate with Visual Studio code as well. So there is an extension for HDInsight, so if you sort of download that extension, then you can start doing all of these queries.
Great.
So here's a final example I'm going to show you. As you know, TPCDS is a big benchmark, mm-hmm. right? So this is a 100 terabyte file that I'm going to demo you with. And look at this SQL complex SQL query, right? This
right.
is, by the way, these are like real TPCDS benchmark queries. We've not modified any of that. Mm-hmm. And so all you can do, I'm just going to right click and say HDInsight Interactive. And this is that same do not delete LLAP cluster that mm-hmm. we demonstrated, right? The files are just sitting in there. And you see it's now running the command, right? This is the command it's doing. And you can see this is the verbose output of saying, okay, what's the size of that data stream? Mm-hmm. That's about 100 terabytes. How do I optimize it, right? And so you saw the results come out right there, right? Overall, it took 12 minutes. It's really 4.9 seconds to do the entire 100 terabyte file scan.
That's pretty fast.
Right, and because you asked that question before, which is, if you see here, it says use TPDS ORC mm-hmm. at the top,
okay.
right? And ORC is the columnar format.
Right.
Right? I'm going to show you the same thing with CSV. Imagine you had a 100 terabyte CSV file.
Mm-hmm.
I can do the same query. I did not change any of the query, so I'm just going to run the same. Interactive. I'm going to go against this cluster. Right? And you see it's going to start executing the query. So it found the schema. It's running the job. Right? And let's see how long this is going to take. Last one was 4.9 seconds, 5.6 seconds.
Great.
But your query didn't change. The answers are right there,
yep.
right? So that's the beauty of LLAP. And we in HDInsight have one of the fastest LLAP implementations out there.
Great.
Fully managed.
Fully managed.
Yes.
And so as a developer, I can just start loading data.
Correct.
I could keep my data in whatever format I'm comfortable.
That's correct.
I can simply point my cluster to that data.
That's correct.
And define some kind of schema to apply over the data so that I can query it and start getting insights.
That is correct.
With SQL.
Right. And it also integrates, like I said, with all the tools, notebook experiences. So you can it can be a developer, it can be a data scientist, right? We got it covered.
Great. Where can we go to learn more?
You can go to HDInsight. If you go to Azure HDInsight mm-hmm. and just search for interactive query, you will have all the documents in there.
Great. Well, thank you so much for joining us today and sharing all the great things we can do with Hive Interactive Query, or LLAP.
LLAP, yes.
LLAP. It was great to see all the progress that's been made in the open source community and how that's coming to life in HDInsight so everybody can start taking advantage of these great services.
Sounds good.
So we're learning all about Hive LLAP, or Interactive Query, today on Azure Friday.